Hello students, in today's video we shall study the relationship between the two houses of the parliament, that is Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha, and the differences. You can underline the first sentence. The parliament, as we all know, it consists of the two houses. Participation and collaboration of both the houses are needed for all legislative functions. So there should be participation, equal participation and cooperation between the Lok Sabha and the Rajya Sabha for the smooth functioning of the government. However, the constitution recognizes, you can underline this line, the superiority of Lok Sabha over the Rajya Sabha. So in certain matters, Lok Sabha has got more powers than the Rajya Sabha. Now Lok Sabha represents the people directly as its members are elected by the people. On the other hand, the Rajya Sabha represents the states of the Indian Union and its members are elected indirectly by the members of the state legislative assembly. So this is the main difference. You can underline all these lines. The Lok Sabha, it represents the people directly, okay, as its members are directly elected by the people. On the other hand, we see Rajya Sabha, it represents the states of the Indian Union and its members are indirectly, okay, they are not directly elected by the members of the state legislative assemblies. They never have to go to the people, and because of this, the Lok Sabha is given an upper hand, or it enjoys more power in many matters concerning the parliament. Now we shall discuss the relationship here below. First, difference over the legislative matters. Now, legislative functions belong to two categories, ordinary bills and money bills. Now, what is ordinary bill? Underline the first sentence. Ordinary bills may originate in either house. Either it can originate in Lok Sabha or Rajya Sabha. And in case if there is disagreement between the two houses, if the two houses have got difference in opinion, the bill is referred to a joint sitting of both the houses. In such cases, both the houses are placed on an equal footing. That means both the houses have got equal power. However, the Rajya Sabha is in a weaker position since the total membership of Rajya Sabha, okay, that is 250, is less than even half of the total strength of the Lok Sabha, that is 552. Okay, the strength of Rajya Sabha is very less as compared to the Lok Sabha. The strength of Rajya Sabha is only 250 as compared to of Lok Sabha, that is 552. Besides, the joint session is presided, okay, other than the strength, the joint session or the joint meeting is presided over by the speaker who comes from the house of Lok Sabha. Now next we have the money bill. Now money bills, in case of money bills, the Rajya Sabha has virtually no powers at all. It cannot reject a money bill nor amend, or it cannot change. Neither can it reject a money bill nor can it make any changes by virtue of its powers. So here in this case, okay, in case of money bill, we see that Rajya Sabha, it only plays the role of an advisory body. Okay, it can only give certain recommendations. It can neither reject nor can it pass. It must, within the stipulated period of 14 days, return the bill to the Lok Sabha. It must, within the stipulated period of 14 days, return the bill to the Lok Sabha, which may thereupon either accept or reject. So which may, here it refers to the Lok Sabha. After 14 days time, again the bill from Rajya Sabha, it is sent to the Lok Sabha. After reaching the Lok Sabha, the money bill can either be accepted or it can be rejected, or any of the recommendations of the Rajya Sabha. So these are the difference over the legislative matters. First we have the ordinary bill and second we have the money bill. Now control over the executive. Members of both the houses can put questions or ask questions to ministers about the work of their department. Now, department here, it can refer to the defense department, the agriculture department, railway, education, etc. You can underline the first sentence. I'll read it again. Members of both the houses can put questions to ministers about the work of their specific departments. But the Lok Sabha is again more powerful than the Rajya Sabha. The Council of Ministers is responsible only to the Lok Sabha. Rajya Sabha cannot pass a motion expressing no confidence in the Council of Ministers. Please underline all these lines. So the Council of Ministers is responsible only to the Lok Sabha. Rajya Sabha, it cannot pass a motion expressing no confidence in the Council of Ministers. Then adjournment motion indicating a strong disapproval of the policy of government is moved only in the Lok Sabha. So we see in all these matters, Lok Sabha, it enjoys more power. It has got an upper hand over the Rajya Sabha. Next, we have election of the president and the vice president. So what role does Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha play in the election of the president and the vice president? Every elected member of the parliament stands on equal footing in the election of the president or the vice president of India. So in this case, in the election of the president and the vice president, both the houses, they play very pivotal role. They have equal power. However, the Lok Sabha has a greater say. Say means it has got more weightage, it has got a more powerful opinion on such matters because of the strength of its number. So it's all the game of numbers here. Since Rajya Sabha, the strength of Rajya Sabha is only 250 as compared to the larger number of Lok Sabha, that is 552. Next we have impeachment. Now again, impeachment, it's the procedure of the removal of president from his office. In matters of impeachment of the President of India or the Chief Justice or a judge of the Supreme Court or of a High Court, both houses have absolute equal powers. So impeachment is a process by which we can remove the President, the Chief Justice, the judges of the Supreme Court and the High Court from their office. So in this matter, that is impeachment matter, both the houses, they have absolutely equal powers. Impeachment can be initiated in either house, that is either Lok Sabha or the Rajya Sabha, and the other house has an equal say in the judgment. Now lastly, we have emergency provision. In case of proclamation of a national emergency and if the Lok Sabha is dissolved, it is the Rajya Sabha which shoulders all the responsibilities of the Union Legislature. So in case of a national emergency or if the Lok Sabha has dissolved before or after the declaration of national emergency, the Rajya Sabha, it becomes the sole parliament. In other words, it has been given the power by the Constitution of India to frame laws or to legislate laws. So the Rajya Sabha shoulders all the responsibilities of Union Legislature in case of proclamation of a national emergency or if the Lok Sabha has been dissolved. So with this, we complete the chapter, girls. Kindly go through the chapter once again and make sure that you have followed everything. And you can go through this chapter at a glance once. This is the gist of the chapter. You can just go through it once. Good day.